What's up, HRV? I'm Christian Furler.
And I'm Alex Bertadillo. Welcome to What's Up, our weekly show about what's going on at the high school.
Today is the opening day of the Adam Sandler musical here at HRV. It's tonight at 7 o'clock and Saturday night at 7 o'clock as well. It'll be running throughout the next 3 weeks here at the Bow Theater.
It should be a lot of fun.
Hey, Alex, aren't you in the school musical?
Shut up, Furley. We sent some kids down to go talk about the show.
So the Addams Family opens Friday the 26th of October at 7 p.m. and runs for 3 weekends. After that, all Sunday shows are matinees, which means they start at 2 p.m. instead of 7 p.m.
The show, it follows two main families who are the Addams Family, more well known. They're crazy, death obsessed, and they live in a strange house in New York City. And then there's the Beinekes, who are Ohio goody two shoes, just perfect from the bunch. And it follows their relationships, their problems, their love, all of that. And here's one twist. Someone is in love and some others aren't. So you'll just have to come and find out the rest.
I play the character of Mal Beinecke, the father of Lucas and the wife of Alice. One thing I really like about my character is that I am super uptight and kind of a jerk. And it's really fun to act out.
And then I'm Alice Beinecke. I'm his wife. And I think the most interesting and challenging thing about my character is that she is endlessly positive to the point where it drives other characters crazy. And it's really fun being so positive and happy all the time, but at the same time, it's really weird.
I play Wednesday Addams, and something that I really like about her is the way she keeps her emotions under wraps. She's very stoic, but she can release them a lot when she tries to, and that's something that I'd really like to emulate a little more in real life.
So I play the grandma, and she's 102 and doing pretty well. My favorite part about playing this character is the physical affects I get to embody, and also because she's completely crazy, completely insane, wants to find a boyfriend, which is funny. Anyway, yeah, grandma's fun.
Okay. So what we're most worried about for the show is it's a really fast-paced show. So that being said, we have really fast scene changes. We have really, really fast quick changes. And the choreography is so intense that you have to get it exactly right or it looks sloppy. So it'll be really challenging, but we're really excited for it.
Welcome to the Senior Hall of Fame for the class of 2019, where we will be announcing the winners for this year. For most likely to become president, we have winners Nando Rodriguez and Montserrat Garrido. For most likely to become a star on Broadway, we have Cooper Case and Freya Chase. As best dancers, we have winners Zoa Mariscal and Brooklyn Holman. And for the best hair category, we have winners Clay Notaboom and Rianne Rhodes. The winners for best muscles were Manny Trejo and Alex Willis. And the winners for best artist are Skylar Beard and Ava Levin. As most likely to become a comedian, we have Ben Arns and Kelsey Stewart. The winners for Best School Spirit were Robbie Running and Emily Curtis. The winners for Best Eyes are Ben Caden and Adriana Galvez. For the most likely to own a farm category, we have Stuart Stallhand and Rachel Mooney. The winners for the most fashionable category are Ryan Zeller and Allison Thompson. As the winners for the friendliest category, we have Zane Yinger and Chloe Sistma. For Best Smile, we have winners Michael Hasegawa and Katie Perkins. For most likely to be in the Olympics, we have Chad Claus and Evelyn Nunez. As most likely to become next Einstein, we have Jason Behringer and Claire Powell. For most likely to become a best-selling author, we have Charlie Bickford and Atari Gauthier. And finally, for the America's Next Top Model category, we have Miles Taylor and Katie Kennedy. These have been your winners for the 2019 Hall of Fame.
In case you didn't know, there's a new class here at HRV called Unified Sports.
It's a class that unifies students with a wide variety of skills.
Harrison, Zach, and Andy went down to find more about this class.
This class is unique to where Special Olympics has set up the structure to where the student athlete is the participant, and then there is a partner, which is other high school students, kind of as an assistant coach or a partner to help students. So the team is actually mirrored with athletes and partners. And so the idea is on a typical game night, you would have a varsity game and a JV game, and then you'd have a unified sports game where you have athletes and partners all participating and together working to play against another team. The benefit is for twofold, not just the athlete participating in activities more than just a one activity day as a Special Olympics day. It's also the other partners that are participating and really including everyone in a sports activity and recreational activity for life. Had taken over the course last year, and we did things such as going bowling and swimming, and we started integrating students and including them here on our campus. And Unified Sports is a new on our campus. It's actually on other campuses in Oregon. It is has multiple different sports and multiple different activities going on after school, just not during the school day. So we're kind of unique that we're going to actually be running a piece of it during the school day, and then there's activities after school as well. The committee has decided to start with basketball as a first unified sports team. We will be playing with the Dalles High School and having a game at their location and a game at our location. Then other unified sports teams in the Portland metro area, like Reynolds and Park Rose, are teams that we're going to look to schedule games with. And then in the future, in the springtime, the OSAA has allotted actual unified points within track meet. So there'll be participants in the track season as well, track and field season. Then a lot of kids are excited about soccer in the fall, because a lot of our athletes love playing soccer, so we'd like to get a soccer team going as well.
Yeah, I enjoy that class. I love it being with my friends more.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think Alondra does enjoy this class. We can't get her to stand still. She's loving it.
Playing games.
So far, basketball. Don't know yet.
Being active.
Basketball.
The basketball part.
Being outside.
I think the cardio part, where she gets to walk and walk around and get her heart rate up.
Got it.
That's our show for the week. Thanks for watching.
We'll leave you with some pictures taken from the fall musical. The song you'll hear is When You're an Adams from the play's Broadway cast.
Come back next week and we'll tell you what's up.
That's good. When you're an Adams, you need to have a little moonlight. When you're an Adams, you need to feel a little chill. You have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some poison in your day.
That's the way.
When you're an Adams, you need to have a sense of humor. When you're an Adams,
you need to have a taste for death.
Who cares about the world outside and what it wants from you? When you're an Adams, you do what Adams always do. Mi amor,
will you love me forever and ever?
We shall remain as besotted with each other as the night we met.
Our first date, you took me to see
Death of a Salesman.
How we laughed. And on my birthday, you brought me
Anthrax.
Even then, you knew my heart.
When you're an Adams,
you need to grab a bow and arrow.
When you're an switch.
And wait till things get hot.
When you're an Adams, you have to really stir the pot.
And
on this special night, we summon our beloved ancestors
to join us for this celebration. And you know what that means?